probably not going to want to go Pokemon. They're just joking about counter picks. I'm feeling a Dreamland pick, depending on what Minty's comfortable with. I'm pretty sure Zets really likes Dreamland. So I'm feeling a Minty pick. Oh, they mean FD. Okay, so they're probably going to want to go Stadium. They don't really care where they go. They're just going to pick whatever. I would think they'd want to go Battlefield. Oh, all right, they're going to go Stadium. Link's a little bit heavier, so Fox's Up Smash is a little bit less potent. I can't say the same for Peach, though. Peach is definitely a light, floaty character. Fox's Up Smash can do a lot. I'm really not sure too much. I don't know too much about the Link-Peach matchup. Stroh did beat Dr. Green Thumb last Ghost House, which, not necessarily an upset, but Dr. Green Thumb no slouch. Link Boomerang is his partner kind of saving the shield pressure from Stroh. Just a bomb, constant aerials and tilts. That was pretty impressive. Zets accidentally SD, got hit by that weird. His Link's up B is so crazy. He like got hit by it and was immediately out of his stun for an air dodge. Or I think he went to tech it and air dodge tracks now. It's like, it's such a weird move. Minty just kind of running in there, breaking everything apart. Okay, I probably wouldn't be doing it. This is just such a weird. Like, I already know what the Fox is going to do. It's like that. Oh, Stroh accidentally missing the ledge. That is something you really don't see from like, Link mains too often, is missing their Zare to recover. They need to have that. So that was. Stroh's boom. He threw his boomerang. Missed him on the comeback and it hit his partner while he's up being like he reacted to that so quick. That is like really good for Minty. I feel like a lot of players wouldn't have even been ready for that. So that was a pretty good back and forth combo. Just a quick little juggle from Peach and Fox just to add some more percent on Link. Missing the snipe, but Ledge had no chance of being grabbed by that Fox. He's just too like. Ledge was pretty much being followed right there. Good upbeat from Stroh. Taking off that Fox so quick. I feel like Stroh should really be focusing that Fox and try to take the stocks off of him because Peach, you know, Peach is just going to live forever. I'm not necessarily on the stage thinking that I'll kill up air or an obstacle or something. Like that up there, I'm going to kill it 100%. So it's like if they get the quick kills on the Zets, I feel like it's probably the best bet. Because at some point, Zets will just have to start taking stocks. You know how it goes. Shines and Nair. That is. Oh, that was really weird. That, I feel like that could have killed if he wasn't ready for it. Bomb down to Stroh. So, these guys had a good chance of a comeback, but like they just got. At, like, they were both at like 20, 30 some percent. And they just both got added up so quickly before they came out. Okay, that. I don't know what that was. Minty, like, waited way too long for the ledge to do something. Like, Stroh was just about to, like, he was already up being, and Minty let him, like, get back on. He just kind of held it. That was kind of a misplay for Minty's part, but I feel these guys can definitely recover. It's only a one stock difference. I mean, Stroh could get a gimp, or Minty could get a gimp on Zets, and then it's immediately back to even. So. Not necessarily even a gimp, like right now I'm pretty sure Fox could up smash and kill Fox to me. Minty gets back there by Zets, and that's pretty much gonna. That's going for that quick up to try to kill Zets really quick. This is sort of looking like he can't. Sometimes, yeah. So Stroh went to hit him. When Link finishes his up, he like puts the sword back in his like hilt. Or the sword holder, I don't really know. He sheathes the sword. And he tried to hit Zets with the ending hitbox of it before it put it back. That was just funny. He wouldn't have won though for that. Team Warm, Zets. Game 1 going to Hanky and Zets, not necessarily a shocker, to say the least, but, you know, anything can happen here. So we're going to go to Battlefield. That's pretty much where I thought they were going to go last game, but they decided against it. For Jets and Hanky's sake, I thought they were going to go Battlefield. They decided against it. I don't know if as Link and Fox, I don't know if I did on Battlefield, but I guess it was just mostly comfort. Minty already losing the stock. 4:30 seconds of the hits. That's crucial at this point. Now immediately they have a hill to climb. That's so rough. Trying to get a quick hill. If you can't get it. Okay, ooh, if he would have just been there just a little bit sooner. Yeah. That would have been it. There's that hitbox I was talking about. Like, he pretty much puts it straight up and like behind him. And just hits him. It's not as good as like the beginning hitboxes of Link's upbeat, but if people aren't ready for it, that's just like a random, like, you're not ready for a hitbox, you don't think it's gonna hit. So right now this is definitely looking like that's something he said. This is definitely not something they can't come back from. This is a 3-stock deficit, but he's got red teams both at high percent. You just kill them both, and it's only a 1-stock deficit. It's like not a super huge deal, but if they really want to make this possible, they gotta take out the stocks quick. This is actually crucial this time. Okay. Zets. Ah, that's rough for. Oh my gosh. Zets 2 shine spikes back to back. Stro and Minty. This is pretty rough. Finally taking first stock, not even by Stro or by Minty. Hanky definitely marrying Zets and killing him. Alright, yeah, this is super rough for the team now. This 4-stock deficit. Minty at 114%. This is. Yeah. Stro would have to get six upbeat kills in 5 minutes. That's not happening. Good news. So that goes 2-0 to that's a big favorites for that. So.